Okay, I'll use my mind this way. All right. Today I'm gonna read another part of the Bible. Take a read Deuteronomy chapter 11. Okay. Therefore, thou shalt love the Lord thy God, and keep his charge and his statutes and his judgments and his commandments all way. And know ye this day, for I speak not with your children which have not known, which have not seen the chastisement of the Lord your God, his greatness, his mighty hand and stretch out arm. And we'll get them later, Mom. My mom is here. I'll wait for him to. Okay, his miracles and his acts he did amidst on the of Egypt and the Pharaoh, the king of Egypt, unto his land. And he, what he did unto the army of Egypt, unto their horses and in their chariots, now he made the water of the Red Sea to overflow them in pursuit after you, how the Lord hath destroyed them unto this day. What he did unto you in the wilderness, that he came unto this place, when he did the Dathan and Abiram, and the sons of Eliab, the sons of Reuben, and the earth opened her mouth and swallowed them up, and their households and their tents and all the substance of their possession, amidst all the Israel. The eyes have seen against the great acts of the Lord which he did. Therefore, we shall ye keep all the commandments which I command you this day, and ye must be strong and go in to possess the land, but he to possess it, that ye may prolong your days of the land which the Lord sware to your fathers to give them unto their seed and land, and flow it with milk and honey. For the land whither thou goest possess it, it is not the land of Egypt, from thus he came out, where thou sowest thy seed and waterest with thy foot, and is a garden of herbs, but the land whither ye go possess it is a land of hills and valleys, and drinketh water in the rain of heaven. And the land which the Lord thy God careth in the eyes of the Lord thy God, and always upon it from the beginning of the year and even at the end of the year. And it shall come to pass, and ye shall hearken the diligently unto my commandments, which I command you this day, to love the Lord your God, and then to serve them with all your heart and all your soul. And I'll give you the rain of your land in this due season, the first rain of the latter rain, and thou mayest gather in thy corn and thy wine and thine oil. And I will send grass in thy fields, thy cattle that thou mayest eat and be full. Take heed of yourselves, and in the heart be deceived, and turn aside and serve other goods to worship them. And then the Lord's wrath be kind against you, and he shut up the heaven, and that there be no rain, that the land yield not to her fruit, that ye perish quickly from off the ground in which the Lord giveth you. Therefore shall ye lay up these words in the heart and land of your soul, and bind them in the sign upon your hand, that ye may as be found this between your eyes. And ye shall teach them your children, speaking of them, when thou sittest with thine house, when thou walkest by the way, when thou liest down, and when thou risest up. And they shall write upon the door post of thine house, and upon thy gates, And that your days be multiplied, the days of your children, the land which the Lord to your fathers and given them, and the days of heaven on the earth. For ye indigenously keep all the commandments which I command you, and do them, and love your God, and walk all his ways, and cleave unto him. The Lord give all the nations from before you, so bless the great nations mired in themselves, in a place wherein the soles of your feet, and so shall you be yours. From the wilderness of Lebanon, from the river Euphrates, and its uttermost sea of coast be, and then it shall be no man going to stand before you. For the Lord your God shall fear the dread of you of all upon the land of a shall you dread upon, and he hath said unto you. Behold, I said before, blessing of the course, and blessing if ye obey the commandments of the Lord your God, which I command you this day. Now, of course, if you not obey the commandments of the Lord your God, in this type of way which I command you this day, and obey our gods which ye not know, and ye shall come to pass, the Lord thy God hath brought thee into the land of whither thou goest, possess it. Thou shalt put the blessing of the Mount Gerizim, and of course, on Mount Ebal. Already not on the other side of Jordan, by the way, where the sun goeth down in the land of the Canaanites, which dwell in the champaign and over the against Gibel, beside the plains of Moreh. He shall pass over Jordan to go and possess the land which the Lord your God giveth you, and possessed it and the dwell therein, and he shall observe to all the students and judgments which I set before you this day. Okay, that's ending of Deuteronomy chapter 11. Next video, I'll read Deuteronomy chapter 12. Okay. Okay, I have to go right now. Thank you for watching this video with Joseph Pye.